ಸಮೀರ್ ಸಿಂಗರ್ ವಿಜಯ ಶಶಿಕರ್ ಚಂದಿತ್ ಶರಜಿತ್ ಹೈದರಿಕರ್ಮತ್.
Oh, good evening. I was just about to send greetings to an old friend. I'm sure modern civilized methods of homicide are much more efficient, but I don't care for them. I abhor violence. That is why on this program we use stabbings, shooting, and garrotings only when they are absolutely essential to the plot, or when the whim strikes us. Tonight's play begins in a museum.
Back in 1990, most of the Kashmiri Pandit community left Kashmir. Those who were fleeing Kashmir knew the reason why they were leaving. But today, it has become a question. A question that is now answered in Kashmir Valley by conspiracy theories and more questions. The answer to the question is not that difficult to understand. My grandfather left Kashmir in a cattle truck. There was a conspiracy, but it was a much simpler conspiracy in which a man kills another man and there is fear. The killers of 1990 and their stories were as simple as their name. This is Bitta Karante, who killed more than 20 Kashmiri Pandits. And this is what he had to say. Listen.
अच्छा पहला पहला जिस आदमी को पहले पहले आपने जान से मारा वो कौन था?
They're probably watching me. Well, let them. Let them see what kind of a person I am. I'm not even gonna swat that fly. I hope they are watching. They'll see. They'll see and they'll know. And they'll say, why, she wouldn't even harm a fly.
पहला मर्डर मैंने सतीश को मारा था. सतीश.
सतीश कौन?
सतीश कुमार टिकू.
टिकू. कौन था ये?
जो ऊपर से मतलब ऑर्डर दिया गया कि उसको हिट करो, मैंने किया.
कौन था ये?
पंडित लड़का.
सिर्फ इसलिए कि पंडित था?
नहीं, वो शायद आरएसएस का था.
तो क्या आरएसएस का होना किसी के लिए गुनाह है? यानी अगर कोई आदमी आरएसएस का मेंबर हो तो आप उसे जान से मार डालेंगे?
मैं मुझे मैंने कहा ना, मुझे ऊपर से इंस्ट्रक्शन मिलता था कि फलानी को मारो. अगर मेरी जगह किसी और को मिल जाता कि फलानी को मारो, उसको मारना था.
So, it's He-Man. Beastman, take the basher and slow him down.
I'll slow him down, all right.
And you and I, dear Evelyn, will call upon the cosmic comet to defeat He-Man once and for all.
I want you to go as quietly as possible. Do not make a sound until I tell you to run.
Benazir Bhutto, this is the same woman who was to claim that she is going to make Jagmohan into Bagh Bagh Mohan. And in a way, it did come true. Today, most of the people in the valley like to claim Kashmiri Pandit isle bhag gaye kyunki Jagmohan ne bhagaya. And he did it so that Indian army could kill all the Kashmiri Muslims in the valley and Pandits are safe. This is known as the Jagmohan conspiracy. a violent movement had led to migration of people from the violence-prone areas. There was a precedent. It came from 1980s, mid-1980s in Punjab, where something similar had happened earlier during the early worst phases of the militancy, Khalistan movement, which was again sponsored by Pakistani agencies. So the instructions were again, and the methods were again coming from across the border. In mid-1980s, as the Khalistani movement took grip of the society in Punjab, there were refugees getting created, Hindu refugees, Sikh refugees getting created, moving into other cities. And in again in 1980s, we hear Kashmiri Pandits for the first time talking about leaving Kashmir because of the rioting in 1986 in Anantnag, which was triggered by the Ram Janmabhoomi movement. There was violence in Uttar Pradesh because of Shah Banu case and reopening of the Ram temple in Ayodhya, and it had repercussions in the valley for Kashmiri Pandit community. These things are pretty simple to see and understand, yet in the valley, because it's easy, the people just claim that it was the Jagmohan. So what was the reason? After 17 years in various jails, when Bita Karante, the killer of Kashmiri Pandits, were released, the public came out in celebration and welcomed him back. They gave him a hero's welcome. So the reason why Kashmiri Pandits left isn't difficult to understand. And it's not difficult to understand why it was necessary for the people who are keeping the violence going in valley to come up with theories and conspiracy theories to prove that Kashmiri Pandits left on their own. Even in November 1990 itself, ISI sponsored agencies came out with booklets to prove that Kashmiri Pandits did it to themselves. And these booklets were distributed all over the world to convince them of a plot that Kashmiri Pandits did it to themselves to prove that Kashmiri Muslims are evil. The wicked Kashmiri Pandit who ran away without a reason. It's as crazy as any conspiracy theory, as crazy as Kashmir. वही लिख लिख के क्या होगा यही सब कुछ चुकाना है सजन रे झूठ मत बोलो खुदा के पास जाना है।